but clean and smelling fresh, even between flushes, for up to 4 weeks. Carpet. Send in the experts.
Hi, how was it?
Oh, yes, thanks.
Did you get a job at a burger bar? Oh, I see you met a girl. Cocktails. And then a lovely, romantic walk.
When you're faced with a range of stains, simply pop open our new tub and let one concentrated aerial liquid tab do the rest.
Don't
worry, your shirt will tell me in the morning.
Aerial tackles the A to Z of stains. So that's another load off your mind.
Mrs. Grinthorpe, B&B again this year, Marjorie. Take that as a no then, dear.
The Holiday and Travel Show at the Scottish Exhibition Centre, Glasgow. 17th, 18th and 19th of January, in association with Bank of Scotland, Halifax. Always giving you extra for your holiday.
Ground control to Major Tom. Ground control to Major Tom. Check ignition and...
Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
Who's gonna catch the night away? The senior leader can swim. Who's gonna catch the night away? The senior leader can
swim. Hear me, Major Tom. Can you hear me?
I didn't mean to hurt you.
You slept with her by accident, did you?
Rachel, I'm sorry.
Oh, you know, that makes the three of us feel so much better.
An act of betrayal.
I asked you if he was having an affair. You looked me in the eye, and you told me I was being stupid.
To protect his brother. Martin Kemp stars in Serious and Organized, Thursday at 9.
Your child is abducted. The kidnapper doesn't want money. He wants you to commit his crimes. What would you do? How far would you go?
What is it you want?
Robbery?
I want you to steal.
Arson?
Burn it down by midnight.
Murder?
A life for a life.
You've got an hour, Lydia, and then he kills our son.
Robson Green, Sarah Parrish, Joe Absalom.
Do you want me to kill your baby?
A drama premiere. Unconditional Love. Next Monday at 9.
Now it's the concluding part of D.H. Lawrence's Sons and Lovers. This programme contains scenes of a sexual nature and nudity.
Rusty.
Oh, yes.
Oh, no! No, no!
McKay and Rusty. Grated potato cakes that go with anything.
They don't have fur of their own, so they're free to use mine. Stress relief. It's my job. I don't let on, but I quite enjoy it.
Well, most of the time anyway.
They're a good boy.
Oh, steady on. I'm only little. I know. Aha. Yes. If you want to pet something, pet this.
Andrex is Andrex soft and Andrex thick.
Good boy.
Result.
Andrex, looking out for the family.
Don't miss your 48-page SMG Travel Shop holiday magazine free inside this Tuesday's edition of the Herald. With over 200 holidays by land, sea and air. From short breaks to exotic adventures. Let SMG Travel Shop take you where you want to go.
Build Admiral Nelson's famous ship, the Victory, and get your model ready in time to commemorate his 200th anniversary.
Darling, dinner's ready.
Be part of the adventure. Part 1, Men at Sea, comes with parts of the model and step-by-step instruction cards at a fantastic price.
Relieve headaches fast with an Ascot powder. Headache? Ask for Ascot.
Nicotin CQ Clear is the only clear patch that protects around the clock. Nicotin CQ, the only clear choice.
It does need something, but why?
Everything all right, Debs?
Yes, fine. Absolutely okay. Fine, thank you. Thank you.
Lee and Perrins with spaghetti bolognese. How did you discover it?
Well done, Debs. Fantastic.
Dettol presents Facts of Life. Fact, trucks can carry cargo you can't even see. Fact, bacteria builds up before you know it. Fact, new Dettol Direct cleans floors hygienically, killing 99.9% of bacteria. No mixing, no bucket, no sticky residue. Fact, kids never tire of making a mess. Dettol protects. That's a fact.
Nick, your face!
What?
Get you a doctor now.
I better go with him.
It ain't no joke, I'd like to buy the world a token, teach the world to sing in perfect harmony.
The totally new Ford Fiesta is here, so get out more. Hey, I know it's just a song, but it's...
I came here to read a prepared statement on our recent successes at Sunhill.
Do we know who he belongs to?
But those successes didn't save that boy.
The Bill.
And this statement won't save other young lives.
Wednesday and Thursday at 8.
What is this life if full of care? We have no time to stand and stare. No time to stand beneath the boughs and stare as long as sheep or cows. A poor life this if full of care. We have no time to stand and stare.
Centre Parks now includes Oasis Windfell Forest in the Lake District. For a brochure, call 087 05 200 222.
Would you call yourself adventurous? Perhaps you're just not aware that you live in one of the most inhospitable places on Earth, where people fight over parking spaces and idiots cross without warning. A place where you must edge out gradually, keep your distance, and offer up prayers to the God of traffic lights. Please stay green. Please stay green. Of course you're adventurous. You just happen to live in Orpington, that's all.
Cravings are hell when you're giving up smoking. But some nicotine gum used to taste pretty evil. Now there's a new gum from Nicotinell, with the power of a patch to help you quit, and that tastes more like real chewing gum. Why suffer more than you have to? Chew cravings away a tastier way with new Nicotinell gums. It needn't be hell with Nicotinell.
Comfort introduces a totally new fabric conditioner. Comfort form.
Shaken, not stretched.
Blocked stuffy nose? Try Breathe Right nasal strips. They gently lift open nasal passages, giving immediate relief, allowing you to breathe more easily. Breathe Right nasal strips, available with mentholated vapors.
It's no fun when you can't sleep.
Time seems to stand still. You just can't switch off. And it feels like you're the only one. But you don't have to put up with it. Night Owl can help you drift off into a natural sleep. So you wake up refreshed in the morning. Good mornings follow a good Night Owl.
January is a fresh start, delivered fresh this morning. It's fresh days and fresh ways to save you money. It's 7,000 prices, cheaper than last year, and a great range of Safeway savers. It's cheap Safeway petrol and deals through your door. Fresh January, on sale at Safeway.
Adhesive cream for a secure fit and hold. Life with more bite.
Let the mayhem begin.
Worldwide media ban. Able to topple governments.
He wanted a relationship with Carver's wife.
Was it something I said?
It's going to be a fantastic show.
Pierce Brosnan, 00 Heaven. Tomorrow Never Dies. Tuesday at 8.
What I want to know is, how soon can my baby get onto solids?
What, just grill it? With an apple?
Dandy!
Steam, not boil, no? I don't suppose you, if you're free this evening, you could come over and show me?
Whether you want simple tips or specific advice on how to eat that little bit better, call one of our advisors on the new Healthy Living line on 08452 788878.
Hello, you still there?
This is what your skin thinks is happening.
I'm in heaven when I'm with you.
And this is what's really happening. New Dove Triple Moisturizing Body Wash cares for your skin in three ways, leaving it so soft, it'll think you used a moisturizer. Go on, cheat on your skin with New Dove Triple Moisturizing Body Wash.
Ever wondered what the most commonly used word in the world is? Okay. Man's favorite word is one that means all right, satisfactory, not bad. So why invent the light bulb when candles are okay? Earth's okay, why go to the moon? Clearly not everybody believes okay is okay. We don't. And we were wondering, what would the world be like if its favorite word wasn't okay? What if we could change it? What if the word was, what if?
Stand up to colds. Don't waste a second. Fight back with Beecham's Flu Plus.
Lost at love before, but you said try just once more. I chose you for the one, now I'm having so much fun. You treated me so kind, I'm about to lose my mind. You made me so very...
With American Express, one phone call to the Platinum Charge Card Concierge Service can arrange to show how much you care, even when you're miles from home.
Don't miss your 48-page SMG Travel Shop holiday magazine free inside this Tuesday's edition of The Herald. With over 200 holidays by land, sea and air. From short breaks to exotic adventures. Let SMG Travel Shop take you where you want to go.
If you experience bladder weakness, Tena Lady will give you double protection. Tena's special odor control system is not only highly absorbent, the balanced pH formula helps prevent odors. Tena Lady with odor control. Why do you think we're number one worldwide?
Why can't you just be straight with me for a change? I mean, what are you, a man or a... Close.
New Muller Lite Mousse. It mousse beloved.
Steam, not boil, no?
It's easier than you think to eat that little bit better. Call the New Healthy Living Line on 08452 788878 for a free information pack.
I suppose you're going to tell me there's been some grisly murder.
Killer drama for Friday nights.
That would be very convenient.
Starring John Nettles.
Detective Chief Inspector Barnaby.
I think we'd better go back to the station, Troy. Find out exactly what is going on here.
A brand new Midsummer Murders. Friday, 8:30.
Travel with Expedia.co.uk and you get more than just a ticket. With flights from hundreds of airlines, over 50,000 hotels worldwide, car hire, insurance, and more. When it comes to travel, we've thought of everything. Have you?
Lobster soup?
Expedia.co.uk.
When you've got diarrhea, you're always looking for where the nearest loo is. Unless you've discovered Imodium Plus. Take it just once and you can be free of diarrhea all day. Imodium Plus, to stop diarrhea before diarrhea stops you.
I'm Joe.
Oh, hi.
Matt's just joined us. How are you
finding? Yeah, everyone's really
it's
nice.
It's a very sort of family, caring, sharing atmosphere.
Oh, sorry.
Told you snack jacks good.
Fantastic, aren't they? Really cheesy.
Less than 10% fat as well.
If you need us, we'll be on the fifth floor.
Right. Snack jacks. Some things are too good to keep to yourself.
How romantic!
A trip to somewhere special. £400.
Cheers! Come along, boys!
A few souvenirs. £1,000. A little culture. £150.
No cats in this one, right?
I don't think so.
A holiday with people who make you feel warm and fuzzy. Priceless. There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's MasterCard. Accepted for all your travel needs. From flights to sights.
Mojo, Symbology, Space, do you speak Micra?
You've just renewed your car insurance. But did you really get a great deal? Did you ask the AA for a quote, for example? After all, the AA promised to find you the cheapest possible quote they can. From one of their panel of recommended insurers. Call 0800 444777 for a great deal from the AA, Britain's biggest car insurance broker. Just ask.
We are family. Come on, you lot.
And we like to shop locally.
I like quality.
Premium yogurt smashing.
Fine wine from Chile.
They're fairly traded, lovely.
Come on down and see.
Oh, and I'm such a sexy sheep.
Ooh.
Dad! Co-op, we go further so you don't have to.
Free serve anytime is only $6.99. Half price for your first 3 months. Visit freeserve.com or these stores.
For a longer, happier relationship, Dunfermline Building Society.
Just find him, please. Find our little boy.
Your child is abducted. The kidnapper doesn't want money. He wants you to commit his crimes. How far would you go?
Murder out of your mind?
Robson Green, Sarah Parrish, Joe Absalom. A drama premiere. Unconditional love. Next Monday at 9.
That looks horrible.
It is. But that's good. It means I ate less of it.
Alpen. Nourishment, not punishment.
I need attendance for my nurse around the clock. Got there no prescription for me. She's the one, the only remedy.
When a nagging cough, runny nose, and an aching head stop you sleeping, nurse it better with Night Nurse.
Night Nurse!
Just dream about starting your own business? There's a Small Business Gateway seminar taking place near you. Call us now and we'll help make your dream happen.
There's a place where magic lives. To get there, visit disneyholidays.co.uk.
Hi. Miss me?
Mm, of course.
You all right? I said you had a crash.
I'm fine.
The car was worse. Direct line sorted it all out, though. Wouldn't know, would you?
Not bad, seeing as you only went with them because they're cheap. They've cleaned in here as well.
What makes you think I didn't do it?
Direct line. Unbelievably good motor insurance that could save you up to 20%. Call or buy online.
It's a new year, and there's a bit of a chill in the air.
You can put that out for a start.
Starring David Jason.
I'm not sending out invitations. Do not think unless I give you permission. Don't do anything stupid. You went out for some sugar.
A Touch of Frost, Sunday at 9.
Coming next, the ITV News, then highlights from Birmingham City Arsenal and Everton's visit to Spurs, plus all the rest of the weekend's action in the Premiership at 11:30.
I was just wondering which of my neighbours would look the part in a nice mahogany coffin.
You think I'm beaten?
I'm not finished. They won't bury me.
Take a life.
To save a life. It's a big, cruel world out there.
Who's going to miss one little old lady?
She slipped and fell. What a shame.
Oh, I survived this.
But I can't guarantee my neighbours will.
Something wrong, Richard?
Never better, Shelley.
What should I do to impress her then, mate?
Have a spring clean.
Start.
I mean cooking wise.
What you got in your fridge?
What fridge?
I'll do your list. You need to get down Sainsbury's, mate.
Olive oil, baguette. Bank loan for fridge.
At Sainsbury's, you can get a bank loan along with your groceries. You get a great low rate and a decision in minutes.
Hello, mate. Did you fill that new fridge up?
Ah, not exactly.
You were working as a waitress in a cocktail bar when I met you.
Now, 5 years later on, you've got the world at your feet. Success has been so easy for you. But don't forget it's me that put you where you are now. And I can put you back down too. Don't you want me, baby? Don't you want me? Whoa.
Download videos and tracks from your favourite artists. Keep up to date with your favourite teams. Play without any interruptions. For free connection and £30 off equipment cost, call 0800 800 060.
I'm the real Arnold Clark. This is the real sale.
It only happens once a year on over 7,000 new and used cars. The real sale at Arnold Clark now.
Yeah, get me a beer, will you? Where's the last safe dial?
What?
No, I'm only joking. Here's your beer.
No, what do you mean after everything I do for you?
I know you do. Just please, not now, please. No.
Not what? Not in front of the kids?
Domestic abuse. There's no excuse. Call 0800 027 1234.
This is Grinthorpe's B&B again this year, Marjorie. Take that as a no then, dear.
The Holiday and Travel Show at the Scottish Exhibition Centre, Glasgow. 17th, 18th and 19th of January, in association with Bank of Scotland, Halifax. Always giving you extra for your holiday.
Olive roll, baguette, bank line for fridge.
With a loan from Sainsbury's Bank, we could get the money to you within 24 hours.
Don't you want 0% finance on any Fiat?
Don't you want me, baby?
Of course you do. Call 0800 71 7000.
At 11:35, it's the Premiership on Monday. At 12:30, Chicago, a celebration. We look at the making of the film. Now, the ITV News.
Rock star Pete Townsend arrested over child porn. Why we must tackle Saddam. Blair gives his reasons.
A direct threat to British national security.
The Queen in hospital after a knee operation. And My Fantastic Voyage by Britain's newest record breaker.
The ITV News with John Suchet.
Good evening. The rock star Pete Townsend was arrested tonight on suspicion of three child pornography offences. Police questioned him at home this afternoon and searched his house. They took away computers. He was taken to his local police station. His name is on a list of 7,000 people who had paid to look at child pornography sites on the internet. On the same list, the name of a TV presenter and two ex-government ministers. Shuli Ghosh reports.
Trying to avoid a barrage of waiting media, Pete Townsend was driven from his London home through a side entrance. The rock star was escorted to a police station in southwest London, where he was taken into custody. Meanwhile, officers connected to the paedophile investigation, Operation Orr, continued searching his home. They removed several items, including computer equipment, which will now be forensically examined. Earlier, Townsend's lawyer said they came at the star's request.
I just want to tell you that we are meeting the police at the house here at 3 o'clock by appointment, by arranging with the police.
Townsend's name was on a list of thousands of suspects handed to British police by US authorities. The Who guitarist admitted he had paid to view a child porn website, but said he'd done it to research a forthcoming book and he wasn't a paedophile. But he's now been arrested on suspicion of possessing indecent images of children, making indecent images of children, and incitement to distribute indecent images of children.
Under the Protection of Children Act, it's an offence to access paedophile material on the internet. If I were to open any of these files to have a look at the pictures they contain, I would be committing a criminal offence, and it doesn't matter if I did it simply as part of a research project or not.
Under Operation Orr, hundreds of suspects have been arrested in the UK, people from all professions, including, alarmingly, those who work with children. Among the 7,000 names being investigated are two former Labour ministers, 50 police officers, a TV presenter, and of course the rock star Pete Townsend, who says he's innocent.
1,500 people have been arrested so far under Operation Orr. 95% of them have got no criminal record, no form of any kind with the police or other authorities.
Pete Townsend is still being questioned tonight. He must now wait to see if charges will be brought against him. Shuli Ghosh, ITV News.
The Prime Minister hinted today he would be prepared to approve an attack on Iraq without UN support, but he insisted he didn't think it would come to that. He was trying to convince doubters in his cabinet and a sceptical public. Scepticism revealed in an ITV News poll. It suggested more than half didn't think he had made that case. Here's our political editor, Nick Robinson.
You may not have made your mind up about whether it's right to fight with Iraq, but today it became clear that the occupant of 10 Downing Street has made up his mind. Tony Blair has sent British troops to fight and die before, and today he made it clear that he's willing to do so again if it's necessary to disarm Saddam Hussein.
Another year, another war. British troops may fight and die for Queen and country, but the Prime Minister's smile can't hide that he decides when they fight and why.
What would you say to a mother who's waved her son off on the Ark Royal and knows that it's at least possible that he will not return because you, in the end, conclude that it is right to fight Iraq?
I would never, as British Prime Minister, send British troops to war unless I thought it was necessary. But there is a direct threat to British national security in the trade in chemical, biological, and nuclear weapons. My fear is that we wake up one day and we find either that one of these dictatorial states has used weapons of mass destruction, and Iraq has done so in the past, or alternatively, these weapons, which are being traded right round the world at the moment, fall into hands of these terrorist groups, these fanatics who will stop at absolutely nothing to cause death and destruction on a mass scale.
So Ark Royal will go to war again, unless Saddam disarms or is removed from power. Today she sailed up a Scottish lock to be loaded with weaponry and greeted by a symbolic protest. For now, they appear somewhat closer to popular opinion than Tony Blair. A poll carried out for ITV News surveyed 1,500 people. We asked, had the case for war been made? More than half, 58%, said no. Then we asked, should British troops fight in Iraq? Only 13%, just over 1 in 10, said yes. But with UN backing, a further 53% would back their involvement. Asked what the real aim of any war is, the number one reason given was oil, 30%, and that's more than the official reason, disarming Saddam Hussein.
You know, polls or not polls, my job in a situation like this is sometimes to say the things that people don't want to hear.
Such as this answer about whether Britain would go to war without UN backing. We want it, we expect to get it, but...
If you did have a breach, went back to the UN, but someone put an unreasonable or unilateral block down on action. Now, in those circumstances, we've said, you know, we can't be in a position where we are confined in that way.
Tony Blair's answer to the doubters about war with Iraq is confidence, arrogance maybe. We will get the evidence. We will get the support, both at home and abroad. War surely will follow. Nick Robinson, ITV News, Westminster.
Remember how the Queen was limping over Christmas at Sandringham? Well, tonight she's in hospital after a knee operation. She'll leave in the morning and will resume normal duties in a few weeks. There are no plans for any members of the royal family to visit her in hospital. Our royal correspondent Tom Bradby reports.
Tonight, the Queen is still in hospital here in London, but doctors say she will go home tomorrow and is expected to make a full recovery. The Queen damaged her knee just before Christmas, a clear indication the fact that she took the car to and from church at Sandringham when she usually prefers to walk. She's always been active and loves to ride. Doctors said today there was every reason to suppose she'd be able to carry on as before. Nicholas Goddard, a specialist who's treated many world-class sportsmen, explained to ITV News why the operation was needed and how it was performed.
We can pop a telescope in through one side of the knee, generally the outside half of the knee, and then we can pop little working instruments like this in through the inside half of the knee. We can then probe and prod, and we can see exactly what's torn, and then using special small scissors and grabbers, we can get in and we can cut out the torn section of the cartilage. In fact, leave the majority of the cartilage behind. It's just the little bit that's actually sort of acting a bit like a doorstop, stopping the knee working properly.
The Queen hasn't had any visitors, but then she likes to handle this kind of thing in a low-key way. Above all, it's been a reminder of what excellent health she has enjoyed. It was hard to remember the last time she was ill, let alone in hospital. Tom Bradby, ITV News, at the King Edward VII Hospital in London.
A mother who slowly poisoned her young son with a deadly cocktail of prescription drugs has been jailed for life. 7-year-old Michael Dickinson spent his final months on a life support machine before dying of pneumonia. His mother, Michelle, tricked doctors into believing he had had epilepsy since he was three, so they gave him drugs he didn't need. The remaining Gibb brothers, Barry and Robin, say they want answers. Answers about the death of their brother Morris. He died yesterday. Today, his brothers questioned whether doctors should have operated on him so soon after he'd had a heart attack. From the United States, Adrian Britton reports.
While musicians and fans pay tribute to Morris Gibb, his brothers are asking whether his life could have been saved had doctors in Miami responded more quickly. Barry and Robin Gibb believe surgeons should have operated on Morris immediately. Instead, he was kept in hospital overnight under observation and had a heart attack before the decision was made to operate on his stomach.
And the fact that they had to operate on Morris during the shock of cardiac arrest
is questionable.
It's very questionable. And we will pursue every factor, every element, every second of the timeline of the final hours of Morris's life. We will pursue that relentlessly.
They describe his death as devastating. Their accusations may be a reaction to their bereavement, but officials at Mount Sinai Hospital in Miami are now under pressure to explain why surgery didn't take place immediately. Medical staff refusing to make any public comment. Barry and Robin say the Bee Gees will continue, though some doubt their sound can ever be the same as a duo. Adrian Britton, ITV News in the United States.
There's more to come on tonight's ITV News, including exclusive, the footballer's wife who nearly died after liposuction.
He just said the after effects would be bruising.
More on that and the rest of the news when we come back.
Aha, a conservatory. My survey may well turn up something here. Perfectly level. Cavity walls, too. Toughened glass throughout. It's C.R. Smith. Isn't it?
It has to be Lorimer from C.R. Smith.
Come fly with me, let's fly away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay. It's perfect for a flying honeymoon, they say. Come fly with me, let's fly, pack up, let's fly away.
At Marks & Spencer, our Count On Us range has over 200 different products guaranteed to contain less than 3% fat. So it's perfect for people who like to watch what they eat. Marks & Spencer's Count On Us range. Extraordinary food every day.
Ross and David Thompson, who own Panjana, never miss an opportunity to show what some companies put into their tea bags. Fiber, tea dust, even stalks. On the other hand, Panjana tea bags contain nothing but pure leaf tea and a dash of pride.
Right. Can I fix your leak now?
The Thompsons start with tea. Panjana.
Sacre bleu, freedom to do whatever you want, and we mean anything. And because FreeServe is now the biggest, the UK's number one, that freedom of expression is in more homes up and down the country than anyone else. But snap it up now, because FreeServe Anytime is only £6.99. That's right, half price for your first 3 months. So join the freedom movement and join FreeServe by visiting freeserve.com or these stores.
Don't miss In Concert, the glittering new show from Holiday on Ice, choreographed by legendary Olympic champion Robin Cousins. For the first time, see musicians play on and around the ice in a sensational combination of live music and spectacular ice dance when Holiday on Ice comes to the Scottish Exhibition Centre, Glasgow. For an unforgettable family experience, book your tickets now for this breathtaking new show at the Scottish Exhibition Centre, Glasgow, from March the 26th.
The news never stands still. That's why at the Evening Times we keep printing throughout the day, updating you with the very latest local, national and international stories.
Found the defendant guilty.
Stupid idiot!
Who wants to read yesterday's news? Thank you.
In January, you can get 5-point Lorimer casement windows for only £2,000.
Brian!
It has to be Lorimer, from C.R. Smith.
Welcome back. Like so many women, all she wanted was a flatter stomach. But for one footballer's wife, it nearly cost her her life. Denise Hendry, wife of the former Scotland captain Colin Hendry, had what should have been routine cosmetic surgery. But as she revealed to ITV1's Tonight programme, she was left fighting for her life. Lawrence McGinty reports.
Colin Hendry was the bravest defender in Scottish football. The newspapers even called his wife Denise Mrs. Braveheart. And she had to be brave when she decided to have liposuction after the birth of their fourth child. The operation was done at Broughton Park, a private hospital near Preston, by plastic surgeon Gustav Annie Jansen.
He just said the after effects would be bruising and probably a couple of pockets where obviously the instrument had gone into your tummy.
But things went disastrously wrong. Denise was in a coma for 3 weeks. Her bowel had been punctured in 9 places, leading to an infection. Her heart arrested. Doctors told Colin she had a 1 in 3 chance of surviving.
I walked out intensive care and I lost it completely. And Denise's dad came out to me and he put his hand around me, and then he said, you know, you've got to be strong.
The guilt was the worst bit, because I kept thinking if I hadn't been so selfish and wanted this done, then I wouldn't be in this position, and my kids wouldn't be in it, and Colin wouldn't have been, the family wouldn't be in it.
11 patients are pursuing legal action against Mr. Annie Jansen, who operated on Denise Hendry. He may yet be blameless, but the awful story of what happened to Denise has once again raised the issue. Who controls the surgeons who operate just to make us look better? Lawrence McGinty, ITV News.
Football. The England striker Robbie Fowler is the latest player leaving Leeds United. He's due to sign for Manchester City for £7 million. The former Liverpool player got a warm reception when he came on as a sub against City at the weekend. He's a hero on both sides of the Atlantic, yet 15-year-old Seb Clover who sailed it single-handed, says being a record breaker is still sinking in. It was by no means plain sailing. There were close encounters with killer whales. But all that was behind him today as he relived his amazing voyage to Antigua with our reporter Chris Shipp.
A day after his record transatlantic passage, Seb Clover is back on the yacht that had carried him from one side of the Atlantic to the other. He invited ITV News on board, telling her sailing is what he does best, surviving in these cramped conditions as he made his way across 3,000 miles of sea. It was a trip no one this young had attempted before. Seb took these pictures in mid-Atlantic during his long voyage to the Caribbean.
Wait to get into a bath, a hot bath, just soothe everything, all the muscles and everything. Just relax for once.
A video diary of his highs and lows. And these huge killer whales, a potential disaster for any small yacht, tracked him for more than 800 miles.
And he'll sort of spin around, show his white underside. The thing is, the sun flashes off that white underside, and all you see is this huge silver, massive line. Bigger than the boat, this is.
They're the sort of moments which would scare even the world's most experienced yachtsman. And for Seb, Christmas Day was just another one of the many spent alone and at sea.
£10. Excellent.
I've got this far to go.
New Year's Eve was spent thousands of miles from the nearest land.
Are you back at school then?
His adventure at sea, the envy of his friends back home who were still at school.
That's quite bad.
His yacht Reflection is now tied up alongside. Now, like every other 15-year-old, the focus for Seb is back to school and his exams. Chris Shipp, ITV News, Antigua.
In a few moments, the best of British pop. From bedroom recordings to the Brit Awards, the streets find out how many nominations he's up for.
Tonight was some beer layering us done our way, but again, we're back in the light of day. Chatting, sitting at the wall.
And who got left out? That's after the news from your part of the country. Stay with us.
Good evening. We must disarm Iraq. That's the stark warning from the Prime Minister, Tony Blair, as he again stated that Saddam Hussein must be stripped of his weapons of mass destruction. It comes as anti-war protesters greeted the Royal Navy flagship Ark Royal as it sailed into Scotland this morning. From the Ministry of Defence base on the banks of Loch Long, Sian Frew reports.
Amid tight security, the pride of Britain's naval fleet sailed up the Firth of Clyde, dwarfing every vessel it passed on its way. Once berthed at the Glen Douglas base on Loch Long, work began immediately, loading the aircraft carrier with vital stores and munitions. The Ark Royal will remain at Loch Long until Friday. Then it will leave for the Mediterranean to join the rest of the fleet before heading for the Gulf. But the Ark Royal's brief stopover in Scotland hasn't been welcomed by all.
It's quite clear that the tide has turned. Even the government's recognising the majority of people don't want a war. And the government's really got to listen to that. They've got to listen to the will of the people. Otherwise, Tony Blair is nothing more than a dictator himself.
But the Prime Minister said that he believed passionately that Saddam Hussein must be stripped of his weapons of mass destruction.
When people say to us, are we clear that we have a justifiable basis for action? If there is a breach of the existing UN resolution, I have no doubt at all that the right thing to do in those circumstances is to disarm Saddam by force.
But those opposed to war claim Blair doesn't even have the full support of his own party.
Yes, someone said the other day that the cabinet is in fact united. Mr. Blair's problem is that it's united against him and his apparent determination to follow George Bush over the cliff to a catastrophic Middle East war.
Meanwhile, Scottish Water and the Home Office have refused to comment on reports that MI5 have ordered that a reservoir on the outskirts of Glasgow should be fenced off because of fears it could be a terrorist target. The security service is rumoured to have issued the demands for extra security measures at Mugdock Reservoir in Mulgay, but both Scottish Water and the Home Office say it cannot confirm or deny reports regarding national security.
A man whose body was found at the side of the A1 near Musselburgh has been named by police as missing Edinburgh father of three, Billy Sibbald. The 48-year-old who helped run a pub in Portobello has been missing since October.
Detectives have launched a murder investigation following the results of a post-mortem which revealed he had met a violent death. A man has appeared in court charged with the murder of 5-year-old Danielle Reid. 25-year-old Lee Gator made no plea when he appeared at Inverness Sheriff Court and was remanded in custody. Police today confirmed that the body recovered from the Caledonian Canal last week was that of Danielle. Gator and two other people have already appeared in court charged in connection with the little girl's disappearance. The mystery surrounding the identity of a man whose body was found in the Isle of Skye more than a year ago has finally been solved. He's been named as 56-year-old Christopher Gray from Kent. His daughter contacted police just 24 hours before Mr. Gray was due to be buried without a name. The wife of the former Scotland football captain Colin Henry says she wants all women to be aware of the dangers after she almost died having plastic surgery. 35-year-old Denise Henry has now battled back to health, but after having liposuction to her stomach last year, her family was told that she wasn't likely to survive after complications set in following surgery. And plastic surgery is more popular in Britain than it is in Europe, with Scots apparently among the keenest in the UK to go under the knife. One estimate points to a 50% increase in business for cosmetic surgeons in 2002 compared to the year before. Claire Dean has been looking at the trend.
Cathy Murphy is pleased with the result of her cosmetic surgery. The 55-year-old says her face had been looking tired and wrinkled. So last March, after researching the options, she decided to treat herself to a facelift.
It's like going for a haircut to me now. You know, if your hair's untidy, you go and get the ends snipped. And to me, it's just tidied up my face. It's not made a difference. I would just say, oh my, you look 20 years younger, because it doesn't make you look 20 years younger. It freshens your face up, is what I would say.
A leading Glasgow surgeon is calling for all clinics to spell out the risks and advises patients to check the qualifications of their prospective surgeon.
This is much more than going into a hairdresser's salon and having a hair done. You have to realise that with surgery, any sort of surgery, there is a basic risk. Now, nowadays it is really not very great, but it is there, and what might possibly go wrong should be explained.
Plastic surgery, though, is not only carried out for cosmetic reasons. Last November, 22-year-old Alex Carroll from Motherwell suffered horrific injuries when a firework exploded in his face. Thanks to the skill of the plastic surgeons, his face has almost recovered. It's hoped another operation will complete the transformation.
A big difference, that's the doctor's office, a big difference. And then I had blue dots on it. A lot of people still stare at you because of the blue dots in your face. Stare at you all the time.
Alex is due to have his final operation in July.
To football now, and in tonight's Tenants' Cup second round, Forfar 3, Stenhousemuir 1. Morton 4, Deverin Vale 3, Raith Rovers 3, Montrose 1, and Stranraer 4, Stirling 1. And that's it from the Scottish Newsroom. Now it's back to John Sushi and the rest of the ITV News.
Hello again. In a moment, the surprise contender for this year's Brit Awards. First, the headlines. The rock star Pete Townsend was taken to his local police station tonight. He's been arrested on suspicion of child pornography offences. The Prime Minister hinted he would be prepared to approve an attack on Iraq without UN support if necessary. And the Queen will leave hospital tomorrow after a minor knee operation. Everyone who's anyone in pop music was waiting today to hear the Brit Award nominations. Ms. Dynamite got 4, so did The Streets, so some new faces, and a new policy on alcohol at next month's ceremony. There won't be any. Here's Nina Nanar.
After a phenomenal 2002, Miss Dynamite's 2003 is looking very promising. She entertained the crowds tonight at the Brit Show after learning she has 4 nominations, a record for a female artist.
I'm really quite overwhelmed by that, actually. I didn't ever expect. I thought maybe 1. But I didn't think I'd be nominated before.
A new day, another morning after. Leaning back on my chair in a greasy spoon cafeteria.
This young rapper is nowhere near as famous, but he has an equal number of nominations. 4 for The Streets, aka Mike Skinner, who produced his album in his bedroom. I just wanna feel. even outdone the king of the Brits. Robbie Williams had the best-selling album last year, but he gets just one Brit nomination.
I don't think it's like a really bad thing for Robbie, because at the end of the day, he's a superstar in my eyes, and he's had such great success here. He's up for Best Male again, which is a big category to be in.
So while the list contains much that is surprising alongside the predictable, one new thing is the alcohol ban in a bid to stop those British rock stars from behaving badly. 4 years ago, John Prescott got a soaking at the hands of misbehaving musicians. But with the likes of Gareth Gates also nominated this year, few expect any trouble. Nina Nanar, ITV News.
And that's the news you can keep up throughout the night on the ITV News channel from the team and me. Good night.
ITV National Weather, sponsored by PowerGen. PowerGen. Power in good hands.
Hello, good evening. We're going to tomorrow on a cloudy note, windy with it as well, and some rain there in western Scotland. We are expecting to see something of the sun, though. If you're very lucky, there are a few glimmers for eastern counties. Much milder than it's been recently. 10s, 11s. 11 is 52 in Fahrenheit. Now, let's take a look ahead, because on Wednesday, we're expecting rain to push down into England and Wales there, brightening up behind. But in turn, those showers turn blustery in nature, and we are expecting gales to sweep right across Scotland there. Now, those gales at times could well gust at around about 90 miles an hour, and that is strong enough to cause severe disruption and some considerable damage. We will, of course, keep you posted here on this channel. And that's all from me for the time being.
PowerGen. Power in good hands.
Admiral Nelson's famous ship, the Victory. Part 1, Men at Sea, comes with parts of the model and step-by-step instruction cards at a fantastic price.
Revolutionary Lemsip Max Strength Direct can be taken anywhere without water for powerful relief on the go. New Lemsip Max Strength Direct.
If you're looking for a healthy alternative, Spanish oranges and clementines are full of fresh vitamin C. Get it into their heads!
It's pouring.
The latest satellite sequence shows rather cloudy skies over much of the country, with a few breaks developing over the highlands. Conditions will remain unsettled during the night, with frequent outbreaks of moderate rain spreading eastwards as the wind strengthens across the region. There will be an overcast, wet and breezy start to Tuesday across all areas tomorrow, with frequent outbreaks of moderate rain developing from early morning. Conditions will remain unsettled during the afternoon as the wind reaches gale force over western coasts. It will feel cold, though, despite temperatures above average for the time of year. Moving on to the Scottish TV fly-through forecast now, and taking a look across Barra and Isla tomorrow, where frequent outbreaks of moderate rain will develop from early morning as the wind reaches gale force during the afternoon. Similar conditions will develop along the Ayrshire coast towards Strathclyde, with locally heavy rain, then blustery showers developing as temperatures over Stirling reach 10 degrees. Moving over towards eastern coasts across Fife and Lothian, where temperatures will reach 9 degrees, although feeling cooler in a strong southeasterly wind, with a few bright spells developing by late afternoon. Looking in more detail over Lothian tomorrow, where the skies will be overcast across Livingston and Dunfermline, with frequent outbreaks of rain spreading southeast, as temperatures over Edinburgh reach 9 degrees Celsius. Now the outlook for the next few days. Into Wednesday, the wind will reach gale force across the country. This will gradually ease on Thursday, with a few bright spells developing in the east. Conditions will brighten up over most places on Friday, although remaining windy. Scattered blustery showers sweeping eastwards can be expected on Saturday.
Scottish weather in association with Kunjana Tea.
Coming up at 12:30, we take a behind-the-scenes look at the making of the film Chicago. Now a review of the weekend's Premiership action. The Premiership on Monday.
Premiership on ITV, sponsored by Coca-Cola.